29. Repeat.
Shattered, shattered glass. I see me. Blood on the window, the land is free.
Hit the revs, boy. Closing in out of the bend. I can take you, Ferrari. You won't beat me. Out the straight, give it everything.
Go on. Take him to bed with you. Do as your daddy tells you. Let the frogs sleep under your sheets. Then in the morning, when you wake up, you'll be surprised.
I want
to
go to
bed. You'll be a beautiful prince.
Lift me up, please.
If you believe that, you believe anything.
What are they trying to do to each other? Cue close up. Oh, that's... Oh, yes, that's marvellous.
Byzantium. Must be Byzantium. Stop, reference, query. 7-9. Origin and date of lapis lazuli brooch. Byzantium.
Pass. Center, good. Good cross, don't hold on, cross. Good, oh, wonderful.
Here we go again.
Action replay, slow motion.
Time warp. Is it reference? No. Never mind. Cancel. On.
Pit stop. Oh, no. 10 seconds, no more. 1, 2, 3.
Reference. Necklace. Mithras. A sun god. Zoroaster?
14 seconds, he's lapped me.
You'll make it, Joe, don't worry. Can't hear you, you know.
No, I know. Oh, it's so strange, Kate. Everywhere so quiet and yet so much going on. At home it was just the wall TV blasting away. You had no choice.
Oh, youth units have the perks.
What were you watching? The Midnight Lemon Boys.
I've never heard of them.
They're a group from back home.
Are you homesick, Sheena?
Well, everyone's so friendly here.
First Division highlights.
What were you viewing?
Oh, I find myself watching fairy stories all the time. I don't know why. I don't believe them.
Well, perhaps you like them.
Give it to her. And roll her over. Get her up on all fours. Oh, yes, it's more like it. Wonderful. Zoom in section 3, frame. Make her groan. That's my boy.
Oh, Adam has a passion for animal activities.
What sort of animals?
Women, preferably. He likes to shock, not that anybody takes any notice.
No.
That's enough.
What?
Can't you do that in your bedroom, Adam?
That is very dangerous, Kate. Coitus interruptus.
You're always trying to embarrass people.
You're not embarrassed, are you?
Of what?
Exactly. Does sex interest you? I mean the philosophy of sex.
What philosophy?
The erection as a metaphor of life. What goes up must come down.
Oh, very funny.
Not at all. You see, evolution is the same as erection. It's not just an upward movement. Now, that is what Darwin failed to understand. He saw only survival, upward thrust, and forgot entropy.
Entropy?
The decline inevitable in all things, including the human species. That is why I watch pornography. As Desaad argues, it is the ultimate expression of human reality, man declining back to the ape.
Thank God we're not all blighted with a public school education.
We are all shaped by our past, Kate. You have not left your nuns behind. I bet you still take a peek at revelations every now and again.
Did you win, Joe?
Yeah.
Another example of entropy.
Brains hatch.
It's evolution. Joe's dad was a mechanic, but his son gets to drive a winner.
Right? Entropy. The petrol car has disappeared because of the entropy of fuel supplies.
What? Where are the aliens?
Oh, they're there. But you never see them. What are you talking about?
2001.
What?
It's an old movie, sci-fi.
Oh, well, computers. Boring.
Oh, there's this wonderful bit near the end. This astronaut has traveled through a sort of dimension warp, and he's going to be reborn soon as a cosmic fetus. But before that, this weird thing happens
to
him.
You surprise me.
He sees himself back on Earth in a hotel bedroom. He's getting older and older until he dies.
But he's not back on Earth, Julie. In the annotated version, the invisible extraterrestrials put him in a room identical with his own back on Earth. Except when he sits down to breakfast, he shakes the Kellogg's packet and blue powder comes out instead of cornflakes.
But why blue powder?
Perhaps that's what extraterrestrials have for breakfast.
No, they have Kellogg's everywhere.
I think the interpretation is they're trying to gently break it to him that he's not really at home. Mm-hmm. Well, all the externals are there to reassure him, with this one indication, the blue powder, that it's all illusion. That in fact he's in another world that he has to slowly adjust to.
Julie, can you stop your fella from kicking me? I have a use for all my parts.
Good job you do. Nobody else does.
Tony.
What are we going to do now?
It's planning time.
And your team lost.
Yeah, I know. I called it live.
That's Southerners.
Midlands.
Anybody get some ideas from what they are watching?
Yes.
Apart from Adam.
I was planning to work on my engine.
Do you ever think of anything else?
Yeah, sure.
Like what?
I don't mind. I'll do whatever you want.
Couldn't we have a party?
Oh, we're always having parties. They're always the same.
Oh, make it special.
Whose birthday's coming up?
Mine's in March.
Mine's February. Okay, Sheena wins. Can be your welcome to the unit party as well.
It still doesn't sound too different.
Well, we could make it fancy dress. Not just junk clothes, but a specific period. What part of history are you keen on, Sheena?
History?
Isn't fancy dress a lot of trouble?
Just because it's not your party.
Not that it wouldn't be worth it.
I'm not very interested in history.
When's it going to be?
February. Your post-war survival training will be over by then, won't it?
Yeah. He goes a young boy, but he comes back a man.
Oh, I don't see you volunteering.
What's the point? If there is a nuclear war, there won't be any post-war for us to survive.
Don't start all that again. What year were you born, Sheena?
1981.
It was around then the Social Democrats started
off. Oh, don't bring your father into this, Diana.
It's easy to mock the government. That's one of the freedoms of democracy. But don't forget, those freedoms have been earned for you.
Well, let's celebrate that then, shall we? A mad fancy dress party on the SDP. You can invite your pater.
What did they wear then?
Who, the SDP?
Well, just ignore him.
Cope dance?
No. That was the 60s.
No good. Owen House held a 60 party months ago.
Let's set up the hall computer. We should find something at that time. I'll get some full-size projections out.
Lucky you.
Do you ever take anything seriously?
Never. It's against my religion.
History. 1981. Britain. General. Random selection of images, stills and film will recall if specific information required.
Do you have to leave this evening?
The training starts first thing.
You don't really want to go, do you?
Well, nobody has to go if they don't want to.
So why do you want to go?
It's important to be prepared.
Dib, dib, dib.
I'll miss you.
I won't miss you.
I won't miss you. Just don't make this take hours, okay?
Come on, you two, pay attention.
Stop.
Oh, look, that's an old VW. Great car. Yeah. Zoom in on the
run on.
That's not fair.
We're looking for clothes, not cars.
Who's that?
No idea.
For me, where the hell can I get one of those?
Aren't those hats beautiful?
Oh, extend reference 765/EPT.
Well, they must cost a fortune. Do you think they wore those clothes all the time?
I suppose so.
They're so elegant.
We could have a party like that!
Oh, I'm not wearing those clothes. Those ties could kill you. It's supposed to be fun, not torture.
Oh. Extend social class reference group A.
Well, we all know who that is, don't we?
The Frog Prince. This one's for you, Kate.
Oh.
Diana, your mother's on.
Tony, look at this. Hold.
Look at that crowd. There must be 50,000 there. Why do they all go instead of seeing it in close-up at home?
Well, they didn't film all the matches then.
Fantastic. Oh, and look at those scarves close-up. Hey, we could have a football party.
But there's hardly any girls there.
We have a women's football team. Oh. You could dress up in the boots and shorts and we'll cheer you on.
Now you're talking.
Run on.
Unfair.
Well, look, if you're not wearing those top hats, I'm certainly not wearing shorts. Anyway, you'll see enough shorts on your course. suppose they are a bit elaborate. We really need something more casual. Back to General. Hold. Is that a youth unit?
Oh, it's probably still an office block at that time. They weren't converted until the need for office space was cut by Microtech, later than 81.
Was that after the youth riots?
Oh, I'm not sure.
What are they doing? Hold. I don't know.
Could be coming out of a football match.
Too many women and children.
Follow reference 973/TRB.
What are they carrying?
Don't know. Can't read it. Close up.
No crews. It's a protest march against holidays. They were mad keen to work in those days.
No, it's the PMs.
What? There's thousands of them.
It must be the time it all flared up.
Are you sure?
Reference event.
Oh, clever Diana.
The original psychomasochist. Fascinating.
Were they allowed to wander the streets like that?
Well, it wasn't diagnosed as mental illness until later.
Let's see some more.
Maintain reference. Run on. Stop.
Look at all those badges.
They're great. You could spend days reading each other.
The crudest form of jewelry. That alone shows their lack of balance. Run on.
Such a bizarre mixture of clothing. They seem to wear anything without any logic. No colour sense at all.
Stop. Look at that shirt. I'll wear that. Store memory, run on.
What's he got all over his face?
Safety pins.
That's not for me.
I'm not going to dress up like those maniacs.
But we wanted a crazy party. What better than the psychomasochists?
We could even invite your father to give us a lecture on them.
It was the Social Democrats who saved us from all of that.
Look, it's only a party.
But we were looking for something with a strong image.
Right.
Well, I suppose it might be interesting to play people the total opposite to us. What do you think, Sheena? It's your party.
I think the clothes look exciting.
Settled. An original psychomasochist party.
Masochism, marvellous. Oh, well, that didn't take too long, did it?
No. Stop. No, run on. Hold. Project wall 2, retract 3. It's open. Hi.
Hello.
Oh. I think I'm fixed on her. Look at that dress. Fancy wearing that with a thick jumper and old man's jacket.
Well, she may have had no choice.
Why not?
Well, son, the kids were poor then. That's why there were riots. Before the new tech paid off.
Can you still get those old skirts, Julie?
Somewhere. Sheena, will you come out with me tonight?
What for?
Well, you know.
You went to see Tony off down the terminal, did you?
I waved him off in me little silk hanky. Crazy, isn't it?
Not if you really care for
him. Of course I care for him.
Well, why didn't you go with him? I thought the volunteer groups were keen on associations.
Well, they are.
So?
Can you see me? Swinging across rivers on a rope, playing Jane to his Tarzan.
You could have made love under the stars.
He's gone to Cheshire. It'll be raining, and I rust in the damp.
It's romantic.
I don't know why he wanted to go. All this post-war training stuff. It's a waste of time.
He'll miss you.
He won't. He'll find somebody else, and why not? Only a fool like her suffers more than they have to. Sheena, come out with me tonight.
Not tonight. I must get my costume together now, or I never will.
Maybe some excuse. Have you invited someone to the party?
Not yet.
Well, you should. All this effort. You ought to get the fun out of it.
I will.
I'll see you later.
Okay.
Julie?
What? If this post-war training is a waste of time, what do you think will happen?
Oh, it'll be a war. People are always making out we're on the verge and we're not. And anyway, if it really comes to the crunch, they'll stop us. That's why they're out there.
Who's they?
Never you mind. Take my word for it, there won't be a war. Is this film or photo still? Back 10 seconds. Run film. Hold.
What primitive ritual do we have here?
You forgot your hour at work.
Oh, sorry, Kate. Got a bit carried away with this. Should I go now?
Oh, no, don't worry. Most of them are fast asleep, dreaming away. They'll most likely sleep through till tea. But if you can remember tomorrow, we promised to take them for a walk.
She's rather nice, isn't she?
Is she?
Q Central, close up.
Oh, yes, she can come to our party.
She's old enough to be your mother, Adam.
Incest is very popular in my family.
Oh, it would
be. I never thought about that.
Well, incest, delightful, it saves travelling.
She could still be alive, could she?
Oh, a lot of the PM survived rehabilitation and settled down to marriage, kids, and a normal life. It's not incurable.
She could be one of those old ladies you push around.
But they're all in their 60s.
Oh, a lot of them look older than they actually are. Nobody's saying it was an easy treatment.
What's that on her coat?
Oh, it's a badge. They all wore the same badge, herd instinct.
What's it meant to be?
Symbol of the movement, I suppose.
What's it a symbol of, then?
Q Central, close up.
Does it have to be of anything?
I don't know.
Maybe it's a missile.
Or maybe it's a tree.
It's a phallic symbol. Oh. Really, the whole movement was sexually repressed. Mm. That's why they got into all these ideological fantasies. If they'd worked it out in bed, they wouldn't have done all those crazy things.
I think it's a tree with roots.
But it doesn't have any branches.
There is no future for the psychomasochist.
Lightning will strike you dead one of these days, Adam.
I never stand under trees.
Do you like it, Kate?
Oh, it's lovely.
I think I preferred it off.
No! She looks so sad in that shot. In all the others, she's smiling. They were sad, Sheena. Full of self-inflicted nightmares about ultimate destruction. Sometimes they dream of an impossible world where the threat of war was just magicked away, and they'd wander around smiling. That wasn't often. Truth is, they really enjoyed their suffering. That's what psychomasochism is. My father defined it as the love of the pain, of hoping for the hopeless.
But didn't they just harm themselves? Why were the new regulations brought in?
Nobody just harms themselves. We live in a society. Everything we do or think affects other people. It became like a fever, especially during the youth riots. When the new Wealth Youth Programme came in, that took the edge off it a bit. But even then, some of the diehards tried direct action against the Defence Department. Then the psychiatric laws had to be established. For their good, as well as ours. They're so cheap, these earrings. I don't think I can bring myself to wear them.
Why would anyone want to hold on to their suffering?
Why do people think they're Napoleon? There's no logical explanation to it. That's why it's insane.
Is she dead now, do you think?
Who knows?
My parents never talked about that time. It was only a few years ago. Might as well be the other side of the moon, for all I know. Why do you think people don't talk about it?
I suppose because it makes us sad. And that's a symptom.
Sound, please.
At a large anti-nuclear rally in this country, while Tony Benn said it was time Britain stood up to the Americans and closed their missile bases here. The CND say the size of today's London rally.
We didn't so much inherit the earth from our ancestors In fact, as we borrowed it from our descendants.
Reference. Caldecott.
Do you know this now? Because I can't see the world stopping this mad momentum towards annihilation until and unless something happens. Do we have to have 500,000 martyrs? Maybe that Titan missile should have blown up the other day in Arkansas and blown up destroyed Arkansas.
Cut. Return to memory. Still 43, no soundtrack.
Look at this. It's genuine.
It's terrific, Joe.
Isn't it?
What does it mean?
What do you mean, what does it mean?
Well, what is it?
Oh, I don't know, Sheena. Films of Silverstone, they all wore little shirts like this with the names of oil on them or tyres.
Maybe it's the sun, natural energy.
Maybe it's just a child's face.
Don't you think she's got a beautiful face?
She must be about 40, yeah?
Well, don't you think she was beautiful? Where's the rest of your costume?
What rest?
You should have jeans or trousers and shoes and socks.
No, I was just planning to wear the shirt.
Well, you can't do that. You've got to do it properly. You can't be these people just by sticking a shirt on.
I don't want to be them. It's just a game, that's all.
It has to be done properly or it'll be no good. It has to be done seriously.
It's only a party.
It's my birthday party.
Yeah, I know that, but... I mean, we don't want to carry it too far, do we?
You have to show respect.
For what? Look, it's a bit of a song and dance, isn't it? Shoes and all.
It's more than a song and dance. It's my birthday. It's the day I was born.
Yeah, I see that, Sheena. Only, I mean, we're not going to go out. And dancing in shoes and socks, it'll cripple us. Nobody will do it.
It'll look ridiculous otherwise.
It's supposed to look ridiculous. They were ridiculous with their daft shirts and badges. That's the whole point.
Don't you care?
About what?
Well, you'd care if it was some sort of car party, wouldn't you? Everything will be exact then.
You don't have car parties.
Car rally instead of a people's rally.
We don't have car rallies anymore either.
Please.
All right, I'll wear the shoes. But if it stops being fun, what's the point?
It will be fun, of course it will.
Apparently all the bombs used on both sides in World War II come to about 5 megatons. So in one bomb dropped on one city, you can quadruple the effect of all the bombs used in the Second World War. And they're quite easy to make and they're very cheap. The bomb, when it exploded, caused people to vaporize and they left their shadows on concrete parapets behind them. That's all that was left. Other people were seen running down the streets with the skin literally shedding off their bodies. And a man was walking past a group of bushes and he heard some noises and he went in there. He found about 20 men, all in exactly the same state. They must have had their eyes upturned at the time of the explosion. And their eyes had melted. And the fluid from their eyes was running down their cheeks. And I'll describe now a dream one of my colleagues had recently. She dreamt that she got to a shelter in Boston, which is unrealistic because Boston would disappear, but it was a dream. And as she was undoing the hermetically sealed latch on the door, she realized that there'd be no landmarks, that Boston would have disappeared. She wouldn't be able to find a way. And then she realized something else, that there would be 2.2 million dead, decaying bodies, with bacteria and viruses mutating to become more virulent, and her immune mechanism would be depleted by radiation. And she realized, as a physician, that she couldn't face the carnage. So what she then realized in the dream was she lacked an adequate supply of sleeping tablets.
And now, a crash bang back to Earth with a message from Scotland Yard. Drivers are warned to stay well away from central London as there is bound to be considerable delays along the route of the march.
Don't worry, I'll get us there.
So beware,
it's just a fault in the distributor. Nothing serious. And now, it'd be too much of a sick joke if we all got blown up in the car instead. You made up your mind to come with us yet?
Well,
what's the matter with you? Bad dreams or is it unrequited love?
Why aren't you wearing the T-shirt?
What T-shirt?
Sam, the child's face.
What is the matter?
I just came to say I was sorry.
What for?
For shouting at you about the shoes.
Look, sit down, love, before you fall down. Do you want a coffee to wake you up?
Why have you got all this stuff?
Why does anybody have possessions? Give them a full sense of security, I suppose.
I didn't know you'd go this far.
Where did you go last night after the film? We were all looking for you.
What film?
Well, the Caldecott lecture.
You've seen it as well.
We all did.
I thought I was the only one.
It's disturbed you, hasn't it?
We can't go on making it into a party,
well,
can
what
we?
Party?
It was supposed to be a party.
We just went to see a film, not a party.
I didn't see the film with you.
Look. Well, look, what she said disturbed me as well. It's a good thing, that's all I know. If it doesn't affect us, what hope is there? That's why the powers won't show on telly. It's like a war game. The scared will react and do something. No, I shan't be sacked.
Angie? Angie, what is it? Angie, what is it? Talk to me. We can't help you if you don't talk to us, Angie. What did you call me? Angie. Angie. Paula? Who do you think it is? I thought it was... The room's wrong. It's not the way I remember it.
Well, I doubt Malcolm's done any decorating. He said the film upset you.
I must have dreamt. It was years from now. We're all in a unit. But it's good. There's good parties. Worrying about the bomb, it's mad. It doesn't do any good. It'll all be all right. It's a waste of time worrying about it. We're all right. I mean, we're happy without bothering about all that. It's mad. It doesn't do any good.
You've had a nightmare.
It wasn't a nightmare. This is the nightmare.
What did you dream, Angie?
The bomb hasn't gone off. It hasn't gone off, I tell you. It won't go off.
Have they got rid of the bomb? Isn't it there anymore?
Of course they haven't got rid of it. You can't put the clock back. They live with it.
How do they live with it?
What do you mean?
Are they happy? Do they have a purpose in life? Are they building?
Building? Building what?
Well, I don't know.
What do they want to build for?
I don't know.
Look, if the nuclear threat still remains, it must affect the way they think, the way they act.
Nobody thinks about the bomb. There's no point in thinking about it.
What else don't they think about? Stop interrogating me.
Running out of sugar?
Oh, that's okay.
It's gonna have to be. It's, there if you want it.
Your gyro come through?
No, I have to go down there. They like to see me queue up and give thanks.
Yes, Elkie Brooks with...
I saw Steve.
Yeah, where?
I was on the bus going to hospital. He was crossing down 4th Street with his sleeping bag.
So long as you don't come round here, I've had enough of his socks to last me a lifetime.
I came to your room last night.
Well, I was in. I came straight back after the film.
I opened your door. I saw you. Poring over your books.
Why didn't you speak to me?
I don't understand you. Any of you. You sit there slogging away over a pediatric textbook or whatever it was, studying like mad for exams, and half an hour before you're telling me the world's going to blow up. It's crazy. You don't believe what you say.
I'm not like the people in your dream, Angie. I'm not just going to give up my future. I'm not just going to accept it. I work for my future and the future of all of us.
All talk.
We can stop it if we all stand against it, Angie.
Well, leave me out of it.
Oh, well, nobody can be left out of it. That's the whole point. We can't get
Angie.
Rid of it.
Maybe we pressured her too much to see the films.
Look, none of us went willingly, did we? We'd all have preferred to leave it to some other poor sod.
Bonos Aires.
What?
He's gone to Brazil.
boat's picking up nuts or something.
Oh.
You could do the touch of this round your house.
What?
Cheer yourself up a bit.
Why are you getting made up?
Why not?
Sue, will you come out with me tonight?
What, on the town?
Why not?
Pick up a couple of nice fellas.
We could. What's so funny?
You're not joking, are you?
You're meeting somebody else.
I'm not meeting anybody.
Well, then why are you getting made up?
For me, just for me. Do you think I'm off on a date before you side the bed's even got cold?
Yes.
Oh, look at you. You've certainly gone worldly wise. But I wouldn't have melted in your mouth yesterday. Look, he ain't just the one night stand, you know. We've been living together for 2 years. We're going to get married and have kids. Mind you, you have to stop at home then. I ain't giving me a job up.
You want children?
Is that so unusual?
Yes.
Well, somebody's got to keep you and Paula in work.
How?
Well, that's what you and her are training to be, isn't it? What do you call it? Pedestrian nurse.
Pediatric.
Not the speed you work at. That's better. You should try more often. Show your teeth a bit more. Sorry I spoke.
What will those kids be like in 20 years? What will I be like?
Watch what you're doing with that thing.
What do you think?
Not much.
Well, I've made it out in the Sistine Chapel.
You're telling me? Well, it's one of the few things keeping the Sistine Chapel standing. Not much hope then, is there? Why are you so defeatist, Angie?
What good are slogans? They don't change anything.
They change attitudes. And attitudes change the world. People can change their attitude and then anything's possible.
Attitudes.
Oh, there isn't time to keep leaving people.
Attitudes don't change overnight.
Yes, they do, Peter. They do. Pete, do you know that?
Oh, you can get it. I know you can get it. All right, look, I'll give you another clue. Bloke walks down the road. His hat blows off. As he runs for it, a bloody huge Alsatian dog nips out in front of him. He tears it to bits. Well, he's furious, isn't he? So he calls the bloke whose dog it is. He says, look, mate, see what your bleeding dog's done. And the bloke with the dog replies, dogs will be dogs, you know? Starts strolling off. Well, the guy is insane with rage, so he grabs him by the shoulder. He says, hang on, pal, I don't think I like your attitude. And the guy with the dog says, take my attitude, it's your attitude.
Get it?
Attitude. Attitude. Hard work. I knew you'd get there. Look, come on the march. It won't work unless we all go, you know? Look, you don't really reckon we can go on living with it hanging over our heads?
There's no point in worrying about it. We should just get on with our lives.
And ignore it? Would that make you happy? Can you do that?
I don't know. There's nothing you can do.
Are you positive? Isn't it even worth a try?
It's going. We'll get there, but I don't guarantee getting back.
Great. Give us a hand with these banners, Mal.
Yeah, sure.
I know what the world's going to be like. You fail. Of course you fail.
We all take a stand. How can we?
It won't be all of you.
Well, who's not with us? You? If you're not with us, we will fail. Will that make you happy? Will that prove your point?
There's nothing we can do.
So we do nothing? Attitude. A self-fulfilling prophecy. Look, even if the bomb somehow holds off for another 20 years, what sort of a world does that create, huh? Sue and Paul are coming?
Yeah, supposed to be.
Who's carrying that banner?
You are.
Oh, no, look, not me. I made it.
That's why you have to take full responsibility for it.
Don't you get tired of being right all the time?
Well, late as ever.
We were waiting for you in the van.
Are you going soon?
Yeah. Are you? What about those kids you work with?
And what about them?
I want kids. I want to breastfeed. Nature's way of giving the best start to a child. You saw that film yesterday because of those tests they'd done. They're finding strontium 90 and high levels in the mother's milk. I could be poisoning my own child.
We can be happy without all this worrying,
can we?
Yeah, and she's right. I mean, look at the ostrich. Happy as the day is long with its head stuck in the sand till one day up comes a randy buffalo. Buggers it. Splat.
Trust you to come up with an image like that.
Next time, I'm going to get a wife who laughs at my jokes.
Next time, I'm going to get a husband who can tell them.
Right, well, we'd better go now if we're going.
Come with us. Please. There's no real way back. For the kids, if not for yourself. Please. Good. Here. Here's a present.
But what does it mean?
It's an ostrich with its head in the air.
Want to get out into the real sun. Julie?
I'm listening. Switched off my Hawaiian trip ages ago.
You could go there. You could travel there. You and Tony could go away together when he gets back.
No, it'd only be rainy. This way I'll get exactly what I want.
Why do you think the bomb won't go off?
It started to rain.
You said it couldn't happen. You said they'd stop it. Who's they?
How the hell do I know who they are?
You said.
I know what I said. They're beings. Beings who'll see we don't harm ourselves. End of conversation.
What kind of beings? You mean extraterrestrial beings? Like in that film you watched?
If you like. Just let me get on and enjoy my tan. I want to be golden for the return of the warrior.
Sort of cosmic parents, and we're their children. They'll look after us, is that what you mean?
I don't want to talk about it.
I thought we came here to get away from our parents, to grow up. But we don't have to, do we? If what you say is true, they'll
stop
see
it,
we should destroy ourselves.
Stop it now.
Don't you see? That's not acceptable. It's not acceptable to think like that, Julie.
It's acceptable to me.
Cosmic parents. I want children. I want to be a parent myself.
Whatever for?
I want children of my own.
You don't know what you're talking about. You haven't even had an association yet. What do you want all the problem of kids for?
We shouldn't be having this party. We should be having a rally, opening up all those questions about the bomb again.
Well, I won't come and neither will anybody else. Look, think what you like. It doesn't matter. But don't try to inflict it on other people.
But we never talk about the bomb.
QFDC. Listen to me, Julie.
I didn't mean to insult you, Joe.
Oh, well, it didn't sound like it. Futile. What I'm doing with this engine is futile, is it? Well, what do you do that's so meaningful?
All I said...
Oh, I heard what you said. Look, don't come here taking out on me what's wrong with you. Youth units aren't for that. The government didn't build them so we could tear into each other.
Who knows why the government built them?
Oh, look, they know what they're doing. They're specialists. They've got facts you and me don't have. Like this manual. You don't know what's in this manual, do you?
No.
No, well, I do. I'm a specialist in this. Each man to his own job.
Your engine won't go.
It will go. I know it can go.
It's not a job you're doing, Joe. You can't ever put it into a car and drive it around. It won't go anywhere.
I know that. I know that. But what do you want? You want me to dream for impossible things? What's the point? Why are you doing this?
Maybe we shouldn't be so happy.
You came here to hurt me because you're not happy.
I just wanted to talk to you about a dream. I've been dreaming about the bomb.
Oh, well, we've had enough of all that. But leave it to the specialist. Leave me alone.
It isn't that easy.
It is that easy. It was that easy for you before you started with all these crazy questions.
They're not crazy.
You'd better be careful, Sheena.
Careful? Why?
Just listen to what you're saying. I don't think you should go to the party. Not like this.
But it's my party.
Not till you've sorted yourself out a bit.
I didn't mean to upset you, Joe.
Oh, they never mean to.
You think I'm mad?
Don't go to the party. Not till you've sorted yourself out.
No. All right.
Ref, MX, track 29, Midnight Lemon Boys. Blood on the window. Land is free.
You believe that? That the bomb will destroy us all?
No question.
Well, then why don't you do something to stop it?
There's nothing to be done. Death is our nature.
But it doesn't make sense.
Of course it makes sense. Only a fool or a child can evade it. Man is a killer. It's his destiny. After he's killed everything else, he turns the knife against himself.
Why do you say things like that? You don't really believe it.
We can't all turn our face away from the truth.
Well, you don't act. You don't do anything as though you believe that. It's just a pose. You believe the same as everybody else, that it'll go on and you'll be all right. You're lying to yourself.
You're the one who's lying.
Oh, stop it, you two. Neither of you knows what you're talking about. You're just playing at being in some sort of film. You think you're some sort of hero. You're not. You're not.
She can't talk to me like that.
Why do you play these games, Adam?
QRF PR 392.
Schoolgirls.
Angie. What?
This Angie. She's right, of course. There is going to be a nuclear holocaust.
But you just said...
Never mind what I say in front of them. It's bound to happen sooner or later.
Well, then we must do something together. We
There's
can stop
nothing
it.
To do, Sheena. Except love and care for each other. Waiting for the day. There's nothing to do, honestly. That's something the Catholics taught me.
We can't just sit and wait.
We must. It's the will of God. We just have to hold on to caring, that's all.
Why?
After the apocalypse comes the day of judgment. Now do you see why there's nothing to be done?
Yes. Yes, of course, thank you.
Oh, it seems strange now, but think about it. We'll talk again.
Yes. Yes, thank you. Help me. Please, Angie. Talk to me. If it occurs, Sheena, we are prepared. I personally don't think it's ever going to come to that.
But we prepare with post-war survivors training for all possibilities.
That's where Tony and the others have gone. If you really feel strongly about it, go with them.
But they say there's no way anyone could survive.
Who's they?
That's not important.
Are these the people in this dream of yours?
All the anti-nuclear people say the same thing.
Psychomasochist, Sheena. Call them by their proper name.
The point is, they say maybe the government's lying to us. Maybe they're just trying to buy our acceptance with all this...
All this what? All this happiness. Is that what they're doing? The government's making its people happy. Isn't that what governments are for? You'd have to be mad not to sell at that price.
Stop talking about madness, Diana. Everybody's always talking about it.
These voices you hear in your dreams, is there one voice you hear above all the rest?
Look, they're contaminating the air we breathe. It even gets into a mother's milk.
It's those voices that are doing the contaminating. Be careful. The government won't tolerate that plague to break out a second time.
What plague?
We're just worried for you, that's all.
Worry about the government, not me, what they're doing.
The government's no different from you, Sheena. There's no them and us. That was all part of the sickness, to believe that in a democracy. They're nothing but our mirror image. They only act on what we think and feel. People want to be happy. The government provides the means. Is that wrong?
No, of course not. As long as people don't bury their heads in the sand.
Exactly, bury their heads, like pretending the nuclear bomb will somehow disappear.
No.
Look, there is suffering in life. We have to accept that. But we can find what happiness there is. That's maturity. You have to stop being a child wanting more than life can give.
That's not right.
We just want to help you. You want help, don't you?
Yes, but not from you.
What is this?
Some sort of trial?
Of course not. You're not on trial.
Why do you think you should be on trial, Sheena?
I don't have to stay here. Give us a chance. Nobody means you any harm. We want to support you through whatever it is.
Sorry.
We understand.
Can you understand?
You're not the first to have gone through this.
What do you mean? Who? Who of you has been through this?
All of us.
All of you?
Yes.
But you all believe different things.
We all believe the same thing. The bomb's a fact and we must live with it. It's you who believe something different.
Our strength comes from common knowledge, shared experience. And that's what can help you through, if you let it.
Do you want the distress you're experiencing?
No, of course not.
Well, something wants it. Something won't let go. Only a part of you rejects our support, Sheena.
What part?
Can we talk about your dream?
What dream?
Can we talk about the girl?
What girl?
The girl of the photos, the girl in your dream. What do you call her? Angie?
No!
Sheena, don't you see? It's Angie who rejects our support, not Sheena. It's that part of you that won't listen to reason.
Angie's better than all of you. Angie cares.
What is it Angie cares
for? I'm not talking about her.
She's real to you, isn't she? You love her, didn't you?
I love her more than I love you. I'm sorry, Julie. I don't mean that. I don't know what I mean.
You love Angie.
I didn't say that.
You did say that.
I said I was on trial. That's why you're asking me all these questions. I'm on trial.
You're not on trial.
Well, who is then?
Perhaps Angie is.
How can Angie be on trial? She doesn't even exist.
And yet you love her.
Do you want me to hate her? Is that what you want? Angie, I hate you. There. Satisfied?
Do you enjoy the pain you cause people?
No. No, of course not.
Then why? You hurt me?
I'm sorry.
Are you?
Believe me.
Do you want us to be happy?
Yes, yes, of course I do.
Do you want to be happy?
Yes, yes, but...
Angie won't let you be.
Stop talking about her, please.
Your dream needs to come out into the open. Share it with us. We can't help you if you don't share.
Please. She's just a girl. I dreamt about her. Her friends tried to tell her about... They tried to make her see that...
Go on. The dream has a meaning, Sheena. We're not denying that.
I was just watching all those old news films. I listened to what they were saying. They said it could be stopped. They were right. It could have been stopped. But she didn't go with them, so it failed.
So the whole movement failed because of her?
Yes. In a way, I don't know.
And you feel for her?
Well, she feels she's failed.
That's her pain. Her pain attracts you. Oh,
she's asking me for something, trying to tell me something.
Oh, yes. All dreams are subjective, but you mustn't take them at face value.
But the dream wasn't really about her. It was about something else.
And yet you talk about her.
What do you mean? I don't know what you mean.
Have you invited anyone to the party? A boyfriend?
No.
Why not? This girl, did she have a boyfriend? She is literally a dream girl. She doesn't exist, you said so. And yet she causes you pain. She's in pain. The pain of unrequited love. Look, her friends try to help her. They tell her to face something, something cataclysmic. The image of a bomb, a good image. Something that will blow up her safe life, the life of childhood. But she stops listening to them. She draws back from them and she stays in her own trap of pain.
Right, Diana, her friends were trying to help her, Sheena, but she had to want to be helped.
Sometimes it's easier to live with that lonely pain than to face reality. Face a real relationship with all its physical presence.
So now you're locked in with her. Locked in with her pain. Oh, it's nothing to do with the bomb. That's only a symbol. It stands on the threshold of her and your maturity. We all have to face it. And we all have. With help.
Don't let your dream girl cut you off from us, your friends. Did you have an imaginary friend when you were small? One day you just left her behind, didn't you? You have to turn your back on them. Nobody can stay a child forever.
But wasn't it about something else? It's not just...
Do what she couldn't do. Listen to your friends.
That's why we're in these units, to help each other.
To support. The fact that love has always been unfulfilled for you doesn't mean it will be forever. Believe me.
Work the dream out in reality, Sheena. That's the only way to exercise her.
Oh.
Good. We'll help you, Sheena.
I'm frightened.
There's nothing to fear. Do you remember those shadows on the wall when you were a child?
Yes.
They weren't there in the morning, were they?
You can make this party a real celebration. A real breakthrough.
If you invite me, I would be honored to escort you to the ball. We'll take you upstairs, love.
Thank you.
Do you think she'll be all right? Shall we postpone the party?
No, there's time yet. Now the problem's out in the open, we can really help. Besides, Tony's expecting a party on his return, isn't he?
Yes.
Well, we don't want to disappoint him. Sheena wouldn't want that. No, I think we should go ahead as planned, don't you?
Yeah.
And now here is the party girl herself.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Sheena. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you. Sheena would like to thank you for coming to her birthday party. She's not been very well lately, but her friends have helped her. And she'd like to say thank you to them especially. To Diana and Joe, Kate and Adam, and to Julie. Thank you. But this is not just Sheena's birthday party. It's mine, Angie. And the year is 1981. Somewhere out there, Sheena's being born. And if you think she goes a bit odd when she gets to my age, you should listen to some of my ideas. So welcome to the psychomasochist party. Enjoy yourselves, but don't forget to suffer a little. Thank you.
Angie blow out all the candles and make a wish?
But all at one go.
Yeah,
go. I'll never do it.
We'll help you then. Make your wish straight away and don't tell anyone.